especially put on my T-shirt. Okay, I make a toy. I name it Q-Box. Q means cute. Q-Box, cute box, just like this one. And this presentation is done by the Q-Box. Okay, let's start it. I control it with my iPad. It is designed for any browser, so you can control it by your cellular phone, computer, or pad. This is my goals. I want to show the wonderful elixir when he is in the little box, the little strawberry. And I don't show any technical detail. I just show, we just enjoy the result. There are nothing new, nothing difficult. It is done almost on the basis what so many smart, kind, and young person had done. So I would say thanks to this person. Okay, this is my outline. I will say a story. That is why I'm here. And I show the functions. At least, in the worst case, you can do this as me. But I think you will do more better. And the third part is what I learned from the process. But I will skip these slides. If you are interested in that, you can. You are welcome to contact me. And finally, I would say thanks again. Because my controller have no slide here, so I will change my position and I can see the slide easily. And I am too old to stand so long. Okay, let me say the story. 1 year ago, I went to something on the Raspberry just for fun. And I asked my good friend, a professor in Taiwan, Mr. Professor Wu. This one is Professor Wu. And I say, I want to build a web server to control the Raspberry. I want to get some suggestion, some advice. He say, Elixir is good. You can do it with Elixir. At that time, I had not heard anything about Elixir. I heard Ruby and on Rails, but I think it is the name of an internet game. I have no idea about that. He gave me a book. I said, I tell him, I cannot read a book. After I finish the book, I can only remember the last page. I'm too old to learn a new language. But the professor Wu said, Elixir is good for human being, especially for an old man. Professor, always be right. So I start this project from last year. I want to build a web-based because I hope any device, remote device, can control it, not to design for every operation system. How? When I say how, I change to Chinese channel. 如果你要知道一个食物好不好吃，最好不要自己试啊，叫别人试就好了。 然后呢，我试了这个 Elixir 跟这个 Raspberry 两个混在一起喝的果汁，还喝了一年，还蛮开心的啊，还蛮好吃的，还蛮健康的。This is okay. When I say okay, I switch to English channel. This is my demo system. Okay. This is Qbox, and it link the speaker with the Bluetooth. And this is my controller. This is a cellular phone, and this is projector. I use the Raspbian, the operating system, which Raspberry suggested. This is a dependency. Okay. Because I do it just for fun, so I do my best to try every function. I use database, Postgres. I use Wi-Fi. And I link C with two methods. One is with port. One is with native interface. And I do, there are two samples of, on the table. One is with a screen and one is not. This is my function. This is the control panel. I make every, this, just like the presentation, is the slides. I divide them by slides, MP3, MP4, audio, video, or photos. And I make this with groups to easily selection. And this is the touch screen. Raspberry Pi have no power button. So I make the touch screen to turn off or reboot, or just make it off. This is another touch screen. When I play the action play, to play the media, edge media is over here. You can select everyone to play. So this is a I make this so many functions. It also a Wi-Fi AP also. And I make it synchronize play. You can play this one and everyone is follow. But I only send a message, no media content. I am a fragment fence. This is the controller page. The left one, this is when we at play, just as now. Left page, next page, and some memos here, titles here. And you can play audio or media here. And this is system control functions, system parameters, et cetera. Okay. Now, this one is the timer. I use it as a timer. You can set the time. And you can set the background. This is what I think a good language is. I think a good language, it must be a good performance. It must be stable, easy to debug. This is the best goal. Of course, it must be right result. And because I'm too old to remember, so I need a language. After some months, I can do that. I can remember how I do it before. And besides, if I give the source code to some others. He can follow. And he can, and this function is scalable. We know the Elixir is the functional programming. Functional programming, I think it is very good for an old man, no memory man, because a function, when you done it, nothing left, only the result. For me, it is just the same. And this is my development environment. This is QBox. And I do it with the CodeView. CodeView can follow the language structure to display different colors. It is easy for me. And I link with SSH. I link to control, to compiler. So this is my development environment. Okay. Something about the technical, I just skip. If you are interested, welcome to contact me. I think this. For me, the Elixir is good for, you can build it to be interpreter or compiler. Even you can, with the nervous, to package the environment. This is a seismography, 地震仪. Elixir 其实很多的工具都已经全了，所以你很简单的，当然你要连上一些线，然后这个做起来还蛮好看的，我就做一个在这边，大家可以看一下。 不过这个地震仪它收到地震资料的时候，它会往后传到云端，那它会做记录。那当然了，如果云端通知你的时候，当然你只有时间祷告了，也不能做其他事。然后我觉得说 Elixir 对我来说好的地方就是它。 他对我这个人来讲蛮好的，他永远有新的东西可以学，他一直有很多人家已经前人努力过的事，这个对我来说其实很有趣，因为结果对我们这种老人来说已经不是很重要了，过程比较重要，就在这过程中我会觉得非常的愉快。Let me introduce myself first. Say I am over, I forget one thing. Play, I forget to play. We see the performance of play. Before the play, I must link the Bluetooth speaker. This is the Bluetooth speaker. Okay, that back to the slides. Okay, let's introduce myself. Say I am over 50 is more polite. I am almost 60. Exclusive coach, not related with technical, only attitude. If you are working, not happy, you can contact me. And I have no Ruby, Erlang, or Elixir experience before. At college, I learned COBOL, Fortran, Pascal. Maybe some of you never heard about that. Maybe your parents does. And I coding in the 10 years before, I coding assembly C, C++, or C sharp. And but I have not coded for years, maybe 10 years, or 7 years. And I'm not a coding engineer, just for fun. And I learned Elixir, no class. I just self-learning with web helps. I spent almost 1 year to do that. So I think, trust me, you can make it if an older man can. That's a slide. I would say thanks. Say all person who contribute over here. I want to thank you. Because you, I can enjoy my coding life. Thank you.
<笑>我们再次感谢邓先生。那我们各位有没有什么任何问题想要做提问的，或者是想要过来看这个 Q Box 的？对，就是你 ，Yeah, you. Do you want to take a look? 你要不要过来看一下？ Yeah, you. Never mind. So, 很 shy. This is a shy audience. Anybody? Do you want to use the intercom?
Yeah, sure. Can do that. It doesn't work.
You just press it hard.
Press hard.
Yes. Hard. And then talk.
I just speak loud. I think that's going to be fine. When you play the video, I was wondering about the communication. Is that, like, where's Alexia there? What is the pass? And then how is it actually being played?
The video play is not played by Alexia. It's an OMX player. It's designed open source.
So the play command is coming to Alexia, and then Alexia is doing his system execution, or how does it work?
Alexia called the system. System call.
Yeah.
Does that answer your question?
Yeah, that was my question, exactly.
I got another gentleman raising, over there. Can you, 你可不可以就是靠麦克风近一点? 那快掉了吗? 那等一下我们请工作人员拿一支麦克风给你哦。
只想请问一下，在这个玩这个东西的过程当中，有没有觉得最有乐趣跟比较挑战的部分是什么？其实我觉得，因为我喜欢程式，最主要就是它可以解决问题。然后我们在做这个
project 的时候，遇到每天都有新的问题，但是很棒的一点就是，当我遇到问题的时候，我就到网站去都有答案，而且所以很快的，我就一个问题一个问题去解决。 所以真正的乐趣是在问题被解决，每天都有一大堆的问题，它有可能是出现在，可能是因为硬体，也可能是软体，也可能是因为我对 Elixir
这语言的不熟。那我们还有没有更多的问题？我们的泰安，不好意思，可以麻烦你给他麦克风吗？谢谢。哦，我们下面有很多的麦克风，可能比可以是。
好，那因为您提到说，在您的那个系统里面，你有用到有 NIF 去控制那个 screen， 然后你也有用到 port， 那有什么原因是让你选择说，某些地方用 NIF， 有些用 port？
好问题啊，那个我用 NIF 跟 port 有两个原因，第一个原因就是我喜欢用不一样的，这个就是因为要学嘛，要玩嘛，就用不一样的，这第一个原因。第二个是因为我用 NIF 让系统宕掉了，因为在 NIF 里面如果有一个无穷回圈，那系统就宕掉了。那系统宕掉了，我就转了另外一个方法，就是用 port。对。
好，那我们还有没有更多的问题呢？ 请。嘿，等一下，可以请我们的工作人员拿麦克风给你吗？这样大家都能听得到你的问题。
在那个 Raspberry Pi 里面，你装 Elixir 进去是一定要透过 Nerve Project 吗？还是就 Nerve Project 就在那个在 Raspberry Pi 上面的作用是？
你说那个 project 就直接recipe 就有提供了，就 apt-get 就可以把 elixir 装进来了，
所以不需要特别装 nerve project。
其实遇到一个问题是那是 phoenix 的时候遇到问题， elixir 没有， elixir 直接 apt-get 就已经做掉了，就是它通通帮你载进来了。对，
有回答到你的问题吗？如果有任何问题的话，我们待会会后都可以请教我们的讲者哦。
其实我可以帮忙回答。
好，请。
就是它Raspberry Pi 基本上是一台小小的电脑，那你可以装作业系统在上面。那一旦你装了作业系统上面，你就可以把各种语言都灌进去。这是 one approach for Elixir， 就是你可以把它当成一台电脑，然后把你的那个。就是语言装上去，那对你来说就只是一台 Linux。那好处就是你可以用到，假设你有你要跨语言还是干嘛用到 Linux 的东西的话，那这样做比较方便。但如果你想要非常节省你的那个 disk space 啊，然后很快的拿到它底下的东西的话，那你用 Nerve Project， 它会帮你把它烧成一个很小很小的 firmware。那你这样子把它关进去 Raspberry Pi， 你就会大量大量的 SD card 剩下的空间可以用。那就是 trade off， 然后而且它就是更棒的那个，对不起，让我重想一次啊。对，如果你用 Nerve Project 的好处是，一旦你用 WiFi 连上网路之后，你可以用 WiFi update， 就是那个东西已经连在你的区网里面，然后你烧了一个新的任体，然后你就跟他说我的 Raspberry Pi IP 在那边，然后这是新的任体，你自己帮我把它丢上去，你自己再透过 WiFi， 它就直接 update 自己，然后自己升级，重开机这样子。谢谢，
谢谢泰安。
抱歉。
谢谢泰安。那我们呢，没有任何问题了吧，各位坐在下面的观众们，没有了哈。Do we have any more questions from the audience? No. Okay, great. Let's give a round of applause to Mr. Dan.